Hey guys, thanks for taking the time to stop by my channel, Autotechnic. Today I'm out working on this Berkeley 12JG pump for the jet boat. And although this pump is rebuilt, when I did rebuild it, there was a few parts that were on back order that I could not get, that I did want to get and have them installed into the pump. Well, turned out my boat needed the stringers replaced, so pump's out of the boat again, and those parts are no longer on back order. So today, so what I'm going to be doing is I will be installing a stuffer, and I'll show you guys how to install the stuffer and also why, what we're going to achieve by installing this ball stuffer, and also be installing an inducer in front of the impeller. So I'll talk a little bit about each one of these things, and I also need to take the ball off and the impeller out and the shaft out of the pump so the shaft can be machined. So I'll run you guys through all that process and show you what it takes to do these. So to get started, is what I'm gonna need to do is I'm gonna need to get the bowl off. Alright guys, easy enough. 8 bolts, slid the ball off, now we have access to the back side of the impeller. So let's talk about this stuffer. Now the whole point of these stuffers, which mine is a domed version, and some people even make their own out of just flat plate. There's all kinds of different versions. It doesn't really matter what you have, they all will achieve the same thing. But the point of this stuffer, or the objective, is for it to seal the cavity on the back side of the impeller. Just like that, because is what we want is the water that's exiting the impeller right here. We want that water to exit the impeller and go into the veins of the bowl. Because what we don't want is that water to curl back and get in this cavity of the impeller and in the bowl and cause turbulence. And that's just gonna decrease our flow. It could cause some cavitation, and it's really just creating inefficiency in the pump. So the stuffer is just there to make everything a little bit more efficient. Now, we don't want this touching when it's in there. So the clearance of that will vary on depending on your impeller. If you're running an aluminum or a bronze, or in this case, I have a stainless steel. So with the stainless steel impeller, it's gonna deflect and not move as much as the other materials. So I can run a little bit of a tighter tolerance with this impeller and this stuffer. So let's look here in the bowl. And you can see this flat mating surface right here. That surface is what's sealing right here on this impeller. And this is set up fairly tight. I've already measured the distance of clearance that I have between the surface and the bowl, and I have about 20 thousandths. And I did that by running a straight edge off the back of this surface of the impeller and measuring to my flange, and then taking the same measurement from the bowl with the gasket down to this flange is there as well. Now, one thing that's interesting to note, that this stuffer is about 116 thousandths in thickness. So if I were to just install this stuffer into the bowl and then bolt the bowl onto the pump, it would force the face of this stuffer to the impeller and it would have everything bound up. So I'm actually gonna have to have my shaft machined to allow the impeller to slide forward some, to open up that clearance to make room for this, which the instructions that it came with did note, and they recommended, what is it, 40 to 90 thousandths. So if I move this the 90 thousandths forward and I had 20 thousandths clearance, I'm gonna have exactly what I need for my stuffer to make the have enough room. So you can see the cavity that's in here, it's probably 2 inches approximately. And then we have the cavity on the back of the impeller, so that's quite a bit of volume. So the stuffer actually just gets bolted into the bowl like so, and it stays stationary, and it's just there to fill that cavity. So all the water that's coming out of the impeller gets directed into the bowl, and we don't have that turbulence and that efficiency. So what I'm going to need to do to get the stuffer mounted is I just need to get the 4 holes drilled and tapped, and it bolts right in. The only downside to this particular style stuffer is this, since this is a Berkeley bowl, it is has bushings in the bowl and it runs the gear oil, so I'm gonna have to drill and tap, which does go into that cavity, and have to seal those bowls up with thread sealant. Some guys don't like that, so is what they will have is a stuffer which bolts on this outer flange into the meat of the bowl. I'm gonna just set it in here, and I'm gonna use the outside circumference of that flat surface that seals up to the back of the impeller to center it. That looks pretty good. So I need to mark where I need to drill the holes, and I do not have transfer punches for that. So I'm just gonna use this old lag bolt, and it fits pretty good in there, and give it a little bit of a tap. And that should have marked the housing pretty well. I'll hit these other ones for good measure. All right. So I'm going to start by drilling the holes in here, and I'm going to do this in three steps to work my way up to it, and then I'll tap it with it's a 5/16 by 18, I believe, which I'll be tapping it with. So I'll get started with drilling these. And there you can see where it fell through. That's where it went into the oil cavity for this lubricated shaft. So a dominator doesn't have to worry about this, but also a dominator pump has a flange off the back of the impeller that kind of seals inside the surface, where you don't necessarily need a stuffer on those. So I'll get these other three drilled. All right, I got the four pilot holes done. I'm stepping up to a 1/4-inch drill bit, and I'll have one more that I'll get my final hole with. I'm going to just drill and tap one hole. I plan on placing the stuffer in, and I will probably drill the three remaining holes with the aid of the stuffer to help make sure that they all line up from where I marked them, and to make sure that it's sitting where I want with the bowl. So first I need to get this drilled, and then we'll work on getting this hole tapped. So now we need to get this tapped. So I need to get some lube for my tap. And just take it nice and slow and do my best to keep this as perpendicular and straight as I can going into the bowl. Give this a little test. So now that I have the pilot holes in, the one bolt in, I'm going to recenter the stuffer, and then I will drill through the stuffer into the remaining holes so that way I have better alignment. And it will sit as centered and true as I can make it. So, good with that. Jump back to our 1/4-inch bit. All right, guys. I shouldn't have drilled all four of those holes in one shot. Lesson learned. The pilot holes, once I bolted the first one in, if I would have drilled off of, I was starting on this hole here, if I would have drilled off of this hole, it would have clocked everything further out than I wanted. And I remarked the hole, and it was off to the right of this one a little bit, but it was not going to drill. It would have left an opening there where I would have had a void. So would have been leaking oil into the, mixing oil into the water, or putting pressurized water into the oil cavity, which neither of those is really an option I want. So what I decided to do is I went and took a 1/8 inch drill bit and I enlarged those holes to an 1/8 inch. And then I took some 1/8 inch aluminum TIG rod, and it was a tight fit. And I actually had to tap that rod down into the hole. And I cleaned up the area around it. And then I'm also going to go ahead and hit it with a torch for two reasons. One, to preheat this aluminum, because it's a gigantic heat sink. And also, it's going to help clean the contamination out of those holes. And once I get that done, I'm just going to take my TIG welder and I'm going to weld those up real quick. And then once that's done, I'll continue on with this, installing the stuffer. And that should allow me to drill the holes one at a time and have them positioned where I want and not allow any oil or water to intermix, and hopefully save myself from this little mistake that I made. I could have continued on with how I did it, but the stuffer would have sat off at an angle and not centered, and I didn't like it. So I decided that I'll just go ahead and make an attempt at fixing it and see how it comes out. So I'm going to go ahead and finish getting this preheated. And usually on older aluminum castings, especially if they've been exposed to other chemicals, whether it be water, oil, or gas, anything. This is also for cast iron. You can see it sweat out once you start to heat it up and get those contaminants out of there. Now this also, since it's aluminum and probably over a 1/4 inch thick where I'll be welding, preheating, it's going to help me with my penetration. So just doing myself a little bit of favor now to make it a little bit easier as I weld. Welded up fairly decently. It seemed the further that I'd go out from the holes where the metal wasn't as clean, it started getting porous and contaminated, to be expected with such an old casting and unknown grade of aluminum. So I just stopped where I was ahead. So I'm going to just go ahead and reinstall the stuffer with the one hole that I initially drilled and get this bolt in tight. And once again, recenter this stuffer. So now I'm going to mark each hole one at a time and then drill and tap it how I should have done it to start with. So that one marked. and get it drilled. Got all four holes drilled and tapped, so I'm just going to go ahead and install the stuffer and bolt it down. And I'll be using some just water-resistant gasket sealant. This is the same stuff that I'll use, say, on a head bolt or head stud into a non-blind bolt hole in a block. And it's pretty good. It dries pretty gooey, so it'll also kind of help a little bit like a real mild thread sealer, or Loctite, I should say. So I'll get this put on the bolts and go ahead and get it all bolted in. Real stuffer's installed. Hey guys, that didn't go as planned, but we're able to make it work. Hopefully you guys can learn from what I did and don't drill all four of those holes at once. Drill one, bolt the stuffer in, and then drill the rest. Don't do what I did. All right guys, like I mentioned at the beginning of the video, it's very important to make sure you have enough room and clearance to install these stuffers. Like I mentioned, you need the machine, the shaft, to push the impeller a little bit forward, and that gives room for the stuffer behind the back of the impeller and the bowl. You need to make sure you have enough room to move your impeller forward and to where you're not going to push the impeller into the suction housing or the wear ring. Also, if you have a shouldered wear ring, this will not work. On top of making sure that you have enough room to move the impeller forward, you also need to make sure that you'll have enough room for the backside of the stuffer to the impeller from this surface. Easiest way to check for me is I'll have a gasket onto the bowl. I'll take just anything that's true and straight, and I'll drop down and measure from this surface down to the top of the stuffer. Do take into account the thickness of this metal or whatever you're using to pull that measurement, and I'll do the same thing. I'll line this back up on the backside of the impeller and pull the same measurement to this flange on the suction housing to find out how much clearance I have in the rear. I know I was going to talk about the inducer with this stuffer on this video, but really this video took a lot longer than I thought with the clocking of the stuffer that I encountered, welding the holes back up and re-drilling them. So what I'm going to do is I will film that in a completely separate video, and I'll put a link here on this one so you can see that, and I'll just do another short video completely separate talking about the inducer and getting my shaft machined and what the inducer does for you. So keep an eye out for that. Guys, I appreciate you taking the time to check out my channel and watch the video. And if you have any comments, please leave them below.